medical breakthrough into what causes cancer, and it may surprise you. Despite common perception, researchers claim 9 out of 31 cancers are not linked to genetics or an unhealthy lifestyle. Instead, bad luck may be to blame when it comes to cell division. So what can you do to protect yourself?
Here to explain is Director of GI Cancer Research Program, Dr. Johanna Bendell. Dr. Bendell, good morning. How are you?
Good morning. How are you? So
we read now that a lot of cancers are due to random, defective cell division, bad luck, rather than genetics or what we eat or smoke. Tell us about that and what we can be doing to protect ourselves anyway.
So this was a very interesting study, and I think pointed out some very good thoughts. One is that we still have to remember that about a third of cancers are still caused by some of these risk factors, like smoking, what we eat, family risk factors. Now, two-thirds of cancers, we think, are caused by the fact that during our normal lifespan, our cells divide. We replace old cells with new cells. What happens is when we do this, those cells can accumulate mutations when they divide. And those mutations can sometimes lead to cancers. And so what we're seeing is probably from this study, about two-thirds of cancers happen almost randomly during our lifespan.
Well, cell division mutations, to me, that's something that would be very hard for me to be able to tell in myself. I know I can make sure that I don't smoke. I can make sure that I don't go and spend too much time in the sun and all of that. But does this mean we're going to need more screenings for prevention and for treatment and for detection?
Right. That's exactly what it means. It drives home the importance that because we can't predict in about two-thirds of cancer cases who's going to get those cancers, that we really have to focus on making sure that we get our colonoscopies, we get our mammograms, we get our skin cancer screenings, all of those preventative tests to that if we do develop those cancers, we catch them early when we can cure them.
Okay, beyond screening and early detection, you also say something that's very interesting and it seems to be so cutting edge, something called molecular profiling in terms of the treatment of cancers. Cancer researchers like you are looking at it, and it's a whole new different world, correct?
That so much is happening now in the field of cancer research. We can actually take an individual patient's tumor and sequence it and find these mutations that might be driving their cancers. And we have a number of agents that are now available, both FDA approved and in clinical trials, they can target those specific mutations to tailor therapy for those patients.
Well, any new information in the fight against cancer is certainly welcome. Johanna Bendell, thank you so much for your expertise this morning.
Thank you,
Dr. Bendell.
Thank you.